In the past few days, the new boss of the ACCC, that's the Australian Competition and Consumer Commission, has been talking the talk. It's early days, but Rod Sims has put everyone on notice, from the supermarket giants and phone companies to those wildly overpriced airport car parks. So who is this bloke? I talked with him a little earlier. Rod Sims, thanks very much for your time. Congratulations on your new appointment. I wonder whether that's congratulations or commiserations. It's a fairly thankless task that you've got. How do you see your role?
Oh, look, many people have said that, George, and thank you for your time. Look, I see it as a challenge, but one I'm looking forward to, George. It's a great opportunity to contribute across a very wide range of issues, and I actually quite like dealing with a wide range of things, so the variety suits me very well.
Rod, let me be pretty basic. If you and I were to go out in the street now and ask Australians what the letters ACCC stood for, what percentage of the population do you think would have a clue?
I suspect a fair number would know that we're there to help consumers. They probably wouldn't have a good read on the competition element.
Right.
And they'd probably have a range of views about how effective we are in doing that, because people, I guess, have a very wide range of views about what we should and shouldn't be doing. So I think the recognition is good, but I suspect we need to do a bit more trying to let them understand why we do what we do and why we don't do what we don't do.
How would you, in a sentence, if you can, how would you tell the public of this country what the ACCC is supposed to do?
The ACCC is supposed to ensure that there's three things. The ACCC is there to ensure that the market economy works as it should and that firms are competing as evenly as they can in a competitive environment, so that firms are competing against each other on a reasonably level playing field. Secondly, to make sure that customers aren't misled, that they're treated appropriately. And thirdly, where competition can't work well, we're there to regulate,
right,
in certain areas that government says we should.
The big ticket item at the moment for you, I would imagine, and you're not be surprised to hear these names coming out of a mouth, Woolies and Coles and the so-called supermarket war. What are you going to do in that situation to make quite sure the competition is continued and the consumer benefits, which is what you think you're all about?
Well, what I've done there, George, is the main issue that's dominating everybody at the moment is the dairy issue, the $1 a litre milk. And what I've said there is when I look at that issue, that's not a misuse of market power on the part of the supermarkets, and there isn't any misleading and deceptive conduct. I mean, the dairy issue is awfully complicated,
right,
but at the end of the day, consumers are benefiting.
Rod, we'll have to leave you there, but I guess we could say that while you're watching, we'll be watching the watcher. All the best, and no doubt we'll talk again.
Thanks, George. Thanks very much.